I've been so alone ever since I left the tribe. That's just how it goes, cause I like the lonely vibe. Yo, what is up guys, SurgicalGoblin here, and welcome to this new video. I'm super hyped for this video because, as you guys can see, I'm on a maxed account. I'm currently 149 in the world. And this is an account sponsored by 50 Kings. So first of all, big shout out to 50 Kings for making this possible. But this account is actually really stacked, like it has almost every card maxed, I believe, except for the Bandit and the Electro Wizard. As you can see, Electro Wizard 3 out of the 20 for level 5, Bandit still level 2. But this account is just insane, and I haven't been pushing a lot on this account just because I don't think it's worth it. But 5 days and 22 hours left in the season, so this morning I actually decided to push a bit. As you guys can see, I am 100 in the top 150 of the world. And as you guys can see, I will share 3 replays of me 3 crowning on max ladder. And these matchups, like as you can see, he had Executioner, Tornado, Lightning. He had Bowler, Graveyard, Tornado. And this actually Backstab X from Hammer Esports. I'm not sure if you guys know him. Big shout out to him as well. He streams on Twitch. He was actually streaming. And as you can see, we were at the exact same trophies. And we decided to just have a friendly match. I said, do you want a match? He said, sure, go for it. And that was actually really fun. So I will just start with the first replay, and I will first show the deck. Actually, I will go over the deck a bit because it is a popular deck, but maybe you guys don't know it. I've been using this deck to get 12 wins in the Grand Challenge as well. This video, I will share it on ladder. If you guys would like to see another video of me sharing some live battles of the last battles to get 12 wins in the Grand Challenge, just let me know in the comments. But first of all, as you guys can see, it has a really cheap cycle. It has the cheapest cycle cards possible, the skeletons and the ice spirit with the collector. So you're trying to basically get a huge advantage with pumping up the 3 muskies. I often use to either punish their poison or to bait out the poison. And if you split 3 muskies in the middle, you will often see people use and their poison and their lock or zap to kill 2 of the musketeers. Then I can go, for example, with the knight in front of the 1 muskie and the goblin gang. The goblin gang DPS is insane. You can always use the goblin gang to counter a goblin barrel. So you can also use the lock offensive. You will probably see that, or yeah, you will definitely see that in the game versus backstab. So this is just basically the battle ram, also super effective offensive. I often block the lightning with the battle ram. You will actually see that in the first replay, which is super cool in my opinion. Let's just hop into the replays, guys. And let's get started. So let's see, I don't start with the collector, which is sort of a bad hand. I mean, I would always start with the collector if I have it in my starting hand. So you'll probably just see me try to cycle and play passive until he drops something. He actually goes with a Hawk Rider. I decide to put knight. I see that my skeletons are the next card if I drop my collector. So I actually drop my collector, then put the skeletons. The Hawk Rider still got 2 hits in, which isn't bad for him at all. But he showed me his lightning, so I knew that, like, that's some valuable information, guys. If he shows his spell, like a fireball, a lightning, you know what to expect. Because now, next time I split 3 muskies, knowing that he has his cycle, he just used his lightning, so I'll actually go with 3 muskies right away. But knowing that he has it in cycle, I can actually try to block his lightning with the battle ram. As I just said, the lightning will first hit the battle ram itself, and then the 2 barbarians spawning it, or the tower, if it's close to a tower, of course, because the tower has the most HP. But let's see, so he decides to go with the executioner on the right side. The muskie on the right side is still doing some work. Knowing that he just played his tornado, I'm actually going aggressive with the goblin gang. The musketeer is locked on, he drops his knight, look at his elixir. He's at 2 elixir right now, while we are at 5 elixir, and he's still forced to defend that. I will actually drop an ice spirit on top of the knight, just so the musketeer can get a bit more value. He goes with a Hawk Rider. I was about to pump up, but now we actually counted his Hawk Rider, so you will see me pump up for sure when I hit 6. I don't know if he had anything to punish except for the Hawk Rider, and he just played that, so I wasn't really worried to pump up at 6 elixir. Normally I would wait until 10 elixir, but right now I wasn't really worried, so I would just drop a battle ram actually to tank for the baby dragon. And the battle ram, like, it will distract it. It will actually allow the tower to kill the baby dragon. But he's still forced to defend those two level 13 barbarians. Like, they're pretty tanky. They didn't get a hit in just because he dropped this electro wizard. But otherwise, they would actually get some solid hits in. Here, I split my goblin gang in the back. He drops the executioner in the back. I will just pump up again. But knowing that he has a lightning, I'm pretty sure I will split 3 muskies right here.
And I have two pumps, so I know that I will be at 4 elixir pretty soon. Here, exactly right now, I drop my Batarang, the tower, and the Batarang and one barbarian will actually tank for the lightning. Two musketeers over here, look at this, one musketeer on the left side. He tornadoes. I know that, I see that the three muskies are next cycle. I'll just drop some skeletons. I'll go with three muskies in the middle aggressive. And I know that he has so, he's low on elixir, so I will just keep the pressure up, drop Goblin Gang. I believe I will go with Batarang, Ice Spirit, whatever. I will just drop everything right now, and this will end up in a 3 crown. As you can see, the lightning block definitely made a change. I outplayed him over there, but me being able to pump up because he didn't lightning the collectors definitely made a big mistake in that game as well. So GG to Mateus from Goose. And now this deck is really popular, guys, and a lot of people playing through muskies. And you would say this deck is doing really good versus three muskies, and it actually is. But if you're able to defend their graveyard and pump up, you can definitely outcycle their bowler and tornado. But let's just hop into this replay. This is actually a really good starting hand. As you can see, both my cycle cards and the collector. So really good starting hand for me. I'll definitely pump up in the middle. And let's see what he drops. I don't think he will go with a graveyard just because he doesn't have any cycle. Let's see if he tries to... Oh yeah, I remember. He will put skeletons and then he will poison, I believe. So I would just drop an Ice Spirit and Skeletons myself, which is actually good. I'm cycling to another collector. I need to place two more cards right now to be at the collector. I believe I will go with three muskies anyways, just because he actually spent quite a bit. And he just used his poison. So as you can see, like, I'm sort of baiting out their spell with a collector. I could have also cycled back to another collector by placing like Knight and Goblin Gang. But right now, I know that he's definitely down on elixir. And we have the advantage. Look at this split push, which is really effective. He doesn't have lock in this deck, which I knew. Like, it's a really popular meta deck. And with meta decks, you often know their cards. So I decided to go on the right side with the Goblin Gang. The left side, the Batarang actually connected. And we dealt so much damage on the left side. I believe over 2000 damage, if not more. And now I'm just pumping up again. Look at his elixir. So we are at 3 elixir, about to get a tick from the collector. And he is at 9 elixir. So we're definitely... up an elixir. If you look at it in a way, you will get elixir from the collector. Here I decide to distract the knight with skeletons. I drop my knight, I drop a lock on the graveyard, and often that will counter it pretty good. I will just drop an Ice Spirit just to be sure. And while countering, as you guys can see, like, we're just cycling back to another collector, just building up such a big advantage in overtime or before, just trying to get a massive push. As you can see, we have two collectors down right now. We're about to equal. He does have a baby dragon on the field, but the advantage we have right now is insane. I know that we have such a big advantage, so I decide to split three muskies in the middle, knowing that he doesn't have a lightning. He will actually poison the left side. I'm not sure if he tried to hit the collector with it, but the two muskies, like, almost fully survive. And I know, as I said, like, this is a meta deck. I know he doesn't have a lock. I decide to go with the Goblin Gang on the right side. He decides to tornado that, but the step goblins will still survive. The musketeer still survives. So that tower will, I believe it will go down. Looks like, it actually does go down. I still lock over here to kill the E-Wiz and kill the skeletons, but it actually went down. Two barbarians, the Batarang connects on the left side, taking two towers. Here, I just know it's over. I will go with two muskies. I will just spam everything. He also knows it's over. He doesn't play anything else. And look at that, another 3 crown, guys. This deck is just insane in my opinion. You're just able to outcycle, you're just able to outplay, like, block a lightning with the Batarang. And this deck is just so much fun. As I said before, if you guys would like to see me playing it in a grand challenge or sharing the replays to get 12 wins or whatever, just let me know. Here I was laughing, as I just explained. I was watching Backstep stream. He streams on Twitch, so definitely go check him out. And we actually were at the exact same cups. Like, it was just a coincidence. Here he goes with the Hawk Rider Goblin Gang. I don't really have a good answer for his Goblin Gang, so I decide to lock it anyways. He zaps, he missed one skeleton, but the Hawk Rider still gets a ton of hits in. But we do have a collector on him right now. Like, he ignored the collector. He didn't have poisonous cycle, so we are up on elixir right now. And I see that the next card is the collector, so I just cycle back to the collector. One key placement right here, guys. You can put it all the way in the corner, but I knew that he had Goblin Barrel because he's playing bait. And here, like right now, you can actually lock it, because normally a lock would not be able to hit buildings. I'm not sure if you guys noticed that while playing, but the lock can't go over buildings anymore. That's also in the middle. If they place the goblin barrel, you can't lock the last goblin towards the king tower. But right now, if I put it in this exact spot, you can actually lock all the goblins if he decides to go with a barrel on top of the collector. Because in the corner, he will just get value. 3 elixir for like 6 elixir. He will take so much elixir out of that. And I don't really have anything to defend it otherwise. So that is why I placed it over there. I'm not sure if you guys noticed that, but that's just a quick little tip. But let's focus on it. He actually decides, that was interesting in my opinion, he actually decides to poison both collectors, which is definitely good. But now look at his elixir. We have 10 elixir, he has 7 elixir. He does have a princess on the field, but we are still getting some elixir from the collector. And I definitely know that he's playing bait. As I said before, he showed the goblin gang, the princess, etc. His inferno placement is really interesting. As you guys can see, if I put the bedroom on the right side, it will actually go for it. But because he dropped his Carmi, I did pre-lock. Because he dropped his Carmi, it actually retargeted onto the inferno tower. But look at the left side, look at the right side, two musketeers going ham. Look at this elixir. I decided to pump up right away, knowing that he doesn't have enough for a goblin barrel. You can sort of keep track of the elixir, not really, of course. But I tried to do that, and I also know that I'm pretty safe. I will actually drop the goblin gang on top of the princess and the skeletons on top of the goblin barrel, yeah. Knowing that the king tower is activated, because he poisoned, as you saw before, he poisoned both collectors. So that is why I actually dropped the skeletons on top of the barrel and the goblin gang on top of the princess. And now I just know that I have such a huge advantage. I have one collector down. I'll go through muskies. He actually has his poison ready. He poisons the two musketeers and he zaps. So that is what I mean with him using their spells. So I believe I'll go with a better ram and a goblin gang on the left side. Yeah, there you go. And the goblin gang. This is just such an effective combination. Like the DPS is just insane. He does drop his goblin gang. He calls good game. Knowing that he can't really defend that. I believe I'll go with three muskies in the middle. There you go. I'll pre-lock here. Knowing that he doesn't have anything else like to drop on it, like a knight or something. All his units are lockable, so I decide to lock right away. I go with a goblin gang. He actually does defend it right here, but I believe he pushes again, and then I will put three muskies. So he actually goes with a hawk rider and a goblin barrel right here. I go with three muskies again, a pre-lock, hitting his goblin gang. Two musketeers are shooting on the tower. I'll drop a goblin gang offensive. I'm just ignoring his push. He can take the tower, but I'm going to take the three crown, and there you go. So as you guys can see, I hope I showed some examples versus different decks to either block the lightning, to outcycle their poison, to sort of bait their poison on the three muskies, then punish him the other lane with the Night Goblin Gang or Better Ram Goblin Gang. It's just so effective. As I said, the DPS of the Goblin Gang is just insane. So feel free to copy this deck, guys. I will probably do another episode on this maxed account, doing some live battles as well. These were just replays because I don't really have that much time. I have exams in 4 weeks, so I will be studying soon. And I'm also focusing on streaming sometimes. If you guys didn't know yet, my request to get a partner on Twitch actually got accepted. So soon I will have some subscribers, as in sub button, as in emojis, etc. So definitely stay hyped for that. But I will, I mentioned this before in the video. If you guys would like to see this on my personal account for the grand challenge to get 12 wins or whatever, just let me know. If you have another deck request, another episode idea, maybe even a series idea, just let me know. There will be actually, talking about backstep, this is a maxed account, but there will be actually a best of 5 versus backstep on, I believe tomorrow, but it will be online in 2 days from now. So that's Thursday. So definitely stay tuned for that, guys. I really hope you guys are hyped for that. The TMD Yao Yao episode went insane. So I do want to thank you all for the crazy support lately around my channel. The views, just insane. So I hope you guys can smack that like button. I hope you guys enjoyed this video as well. If you did, feel free to subscribe. And I hope to see you on one of my next videos. Bye.